The mature view is this. It's not only what you set into motion that's going to bear a result. A lot of other things have to gang up and bring about the success, bring about the result. And the example I use with the children is very simple. They say, I'm so clever, I got A star, 100%. I say, my boy, it's not only you. Your mommy had to drag you here, you know, make lunch for you, pay for everything, pay the fees, everything. So it's not only your action that has produced this A star, 100%. A lot of other people have ganged up and helped you along. This is the mature understanding of law of karma. It's not only what you set into motion, a lot of other, not one, million things gang up before you get a result. You have contributed towards your future, but be careful. A lot of other things interfere with your future because we forget that part of the equation. And I'll give you a classic example. If you see a disabled person in the Hindu tradition, it's a horrible thing. You know, first thing they'll say, he deserves it. He must have done something bad. Bad karma. So he's catching up and that's why he's getting his hand. This is a horrible thing to say. It's the most nonsensical thing because a lot of things gang up. So the poor man may have nothing to do with it. Some idiot ran over his arm and broke his arm. So what has he done? Or the tsunami hit him. So be careful when you understand the law of karma in its full maturity. It's not only what you set into motion, a lot of other things gang up and produce a result.